Okay, new video here. I'm fitting this big old spare tire under my 1998 GMC Safari van. See if it fits. So this is a 265/70 R15 on a 15-inch rim, which is actually slightly different than my 255/70 R17 tires. I cannot find this rim anywhere close or at a reasonable price. So that led me to just get any rim that theoretically should fit and a tire. Technically not the same, you should always have exact matching, but this is actually my total emergency spare. I'll show you what plan A is. So plan A is an air compressor. This is a Smittybilt 2781. Had it for quite a while, used it in my 4Runner with 35s, and it inflates the tires like pretty fast. My other buddy has an ARB like compressor in a case that he spent considerably more money on than I did. And performance wise, like exactly the same. Recommend the Smittybilt. And then I got this tire kit, which should allow me to plug any sort of issue to inflate my tire. So I will never actually use this spare tire. So that's basically why I went with slightly mismatching tires. So don't do that. Don't do what I do, do what I say. But anyways, I'm gonna test fit this one because I did originally buy a tire that I think was from a Jeep Patriot. That was a 16-inch thing, but the hole was too small. That does not fit. That hole is too small. So I gotta test fit it, make sure it fits, and then we're gonna stick it underneath. Let's go. This thing in here. Okay, I have one issue here. I'm gonna have to relocate this breather. Dirt in my eye. I gotta relocate that breather because the tire is gonna come up and squish that, so it needs to be done. One other thing I have noticed now that I'm under here, this is not in the center, so I might have to do some sort of whatever, some custom rigging with a ratchet strap, but I got plenty of ratchet straps, so I'm gonna relocate that breather and then try to hoist this thing up and see what happens. So in order to actually access my tire hoist, I had to pry my doors out of the way because my doors randomly stopped working and I realized I was not going to fix them before my big trip. So I actually had to bend them to access the hoist point. So that's like another pro tip. If you're going to count on a spare tire, always make sure that your hoist is going to work. Like make sure your doors work, make sure you got the tools, and make sure it's not seized up. Because if you're in a situation where you need your spare tire and you cannot access it, you're gonna be having a problem. So that's just words of advice.
Feel like I'm kind of too tight on the diff here, so I think I might pry on it.
As I was under here, I realized what my actual course of action was going to be, and that was to attach a couple ratchet straps
to the spare tire itself. So through a bolt hole, I attached the hook and I ratchet strapped to my hitch. So it pulled it back away from the diff towards the hitch. One on each side, so that should be plenty strong because that hitch ain't going nowhere. And at this point, it's just a matter of adjusting both ratchet straps and the tire hoist to get it all exactly where I want it, living in spare tire harmony.
Okay. I got two things there. Clearance all around, a little tight there, but I think that's gonna be good to go. Obviously, I gotta tie these or cut them or both, tighten up that thing, but I think this looks pretty friggin' good.
Good.
So, ratchet it up tight here. This is not touching, but I'm not hung up on anything, I don't believe. But I believe, because the ratchet straps were holding it so tight, this is gonna hang that way, but I'm just gonna leave it. This does feel very solid, so I'm gonna go on 4x4 camping this weekend. I probably won't be taking you guys, but I am doing that. And I'm gonna make sure it doesn't fall off, but you can definitely fit a 31-inch tire in here. I would not want to go any bigger, because you're gonna have issues here. Unless you get rid of a hitch. Anyways, I'm gonna hop out here, make sure my tire is tight. Peace.
False alarm. I'm actually back under here adding a third ratchet strap. I kind of realized I needed a safety strap, because while these ratchet straps were holding it backwards in order for me to fit the tire, they were adding nothing for like strength. And this tire hoist is originally designed for a way smaller tire. So I realized I needed some support. So I had to come back here and add another ratchet strap.
Okay, so I actually am back under here. I was all done wrapped up. And then I had a bit of a clarity break. I ate a little smoke session of that Canadian legal stuff. And I realized that I kind of wanted slash needed a safety strap. So I put it up in that to that cross member there, all the way back to the hitch. So now this thing is cinched to the back. You just have it cinched backwards. It's being held up with the original tire hoist and a safety strap. I just had like this thought of, I wonder if these are putting more pressure on the original thing. So I was like, I need a safety strap. So that, yeah. So now we'll just go back to the original video now, but I need to cut myself off to say I put that in. Still fits good. Looks a little ghetto, but anyways, back to the video. Actually, what I am gonna do is bend this back. I kind of want to notch it, but I'm just going to bend it back. I always have my pry bars with me, so if I have to change that on the road, I'll just pry it back open. Yeah, and then I'm going to make sure my rim is tight. Okay, so I am back. I went 4x4 camping, and I wanted to show you two things. First, what this looks like from the back. You can obviously see the ratchet straps.
I probably shouldn't have used bright orange, but personally, I don't really care. But you can see it from the back, which is not always the best for everybody. But if you're considering to use black or camo, you won't even see them. But it also held totally fine. I went proper off-roading. Honestly, a little bit sketchier than I would have liked to have gone off-roading. But it held up totally fine. All these ratchet straps are still tight. All my knots are tied. So that being said, that's it. That's the end of this video. Fitting an oversized spare under a lifted GMC Safari. Peace.